Hey, Coach Justin from Ultimate Baseball Training, and in today's video, we're going to talk about should you swing a wood or an aluminum baseball bat. We're going to go over the pros and cons of both wood and aluminum, and I'm going to give you my personal recommendation for what I believe you need to be swinging to really play to your full potential on the field. So let's just get straight into it. All right, so wood or aluminum bats? First, let's talk about aluminum bats. Why are aluminum bats so popular in pretty much every single rank of baseball, right? We got youth players using aluminum bats, high school players, college players. Why are all of them using aluminum bats, right? And I think you know the answer, but I just want to get into a few pros and cons of both aluminum and wood bats before I tell you my personal recommendation for you. So the very first thing, the first advantage, if you want to call it that, for an aluminum bat is they have a bigger sweet spot, okay? The sweet spot of the bat is where you ideally want to make contact with the baseball. And on an aluminum bat, the sweet spot is much larger. What does that mean? Well, that means that there is a greater margin of error. So what does that mean? Well, that means that you can actually miss hit the baseball on an aluminum bat. You can hit it a little bit closer to your hands, a little bit in here, tight to your body, or a little bit further out here towards the end of the bat, and you still might get a base hit, okay? So all in all, a good word to describe aluminum bats is forgiving. They're more forgiving than wood bats. Another obvious big time advantage for aluminum bats is that they don't break, or at least they don't break very often, right? Occasionally you'll see an aluminum bat break, and it's kind of a rare sight to see something like that, but they break a heck of a lot less than wood bats do. So that's nice for, you know, your pocketbook, because you're not always running to the sporting goods store and buying new baseball bats all the time. And the reason why aluminum bats don't break is because it's a stronger material. And again, it goes back to being more forgiving. Another big advantage for aluminum bats over wood bats is aluminum bats have what's called the trampoline effect. Now, there's a lot of science behind the trampoline effect. Feel free to do your research on it, but the gist of it is this, okay? Obviously, the pitch is thrown from the pitcher's hand and it's coming in, and with a wood baseball bat, when the ball makes contact with the bat, the ball actually compresses more on a wood baseball bat, okay? So think of compression, think of like dribbling a basketball. When that basketball hits the ground, obviously it compresses before it bounces back up, right? Well, the same thing happens when the ball makes contact with a wood baseball bat. The ball does the majority of the compressing. What that means is the ball compresses, it loses a lot of its energy, and so it doesn't fly off in the opposite direction quite as hard, and you can't hit it quite as far as with an aluminum bat. Now, why do aluminum bats have more pop? Well, it's because of the trampoline effect, and what an aluminum bat does is it actually keeps more energy in the ball, because the baseball bat itself, when the bat and the ball collide, the baseball bat itself does more of the bending, I guess you could say, or more of the compression than the ball, okay? So that's the trampoline effect, and that's really what allows you to hit the ball a lot harder and a lot further with an aluminum bat over a wood bat. So aluminum bats are probably sounding really good right about now, but now let's get into wood bats a little bit, all right? The very first thing with a wood bat, which is the opposite of an aluminum bat, is obviously the sweet spot on a wood baseball bat is much smaller, so you have to be much more accurate. You actually have to square up the baseball with a wood bat. So what does that mean? How does that benefit you? Well, if you have to square up the baseball more often, it's gonna provide more honest feedback on how good of a job you're doing that, okay? So a great example is, let's put this tee up here like this, resembling an inside pitch. And if this was an aluminum baseball bat, if I were to make contact in here like this with an aluminum baseball bat, that's clearly not on the sweet spot, but because aluminum bats are much more forgiving, I might get a base hit out of that, okay? So that's gonna provide, when I switch over to wood, if I still hit the ball right there, that's gonna provide feedback. I'm basically hitting the ball on the label there, this label here, that's gonna provide feedback that, hey, I need to work on hitting that inside pitch because I can't handle that right now and I'm breaking my bats. And speaking of broken bats, yes, wood bats break, and they break a heck of a lot more often than aluminum baseball bats do. And so they really reveal the holes in your swing, your strengths and your weaknesses. Like I mentioned, you know, especially for you younger hitters, you might be able to get away with hitting the ball not perfectly on the sweet spot, okay? You might be hitting the ball too close to your body, or you might be hitting the ball too much on the end of the bat like this, and you might be able to get away with that with an aluminum bat, but that's not gonna hold true with a wood bat. And the last thing I wanna touch on before I give you my recommendation is that wood bats force you to have better strike zone awareness and better plate discipline. Because if you start swinging at bad pitches, if you start swinging at pitches that are outside the strike zone, let's say, you know, a low and away pitch that might not be a strike, if you start swinging at pitches like that and you hit it off the end of the bat, that could literally cost you. It could cost you in your hand stinging, right? It could cost you when you break your bat or chip your bat and you have to go buy a new one. And so that's something that wood bats definitely have over aluminum bats, is they force you to really work on your plate discipline, because you might be able to get away again with mishitting a particular pitch with an aluminum bat. You're not gonna be able to get away with that with a wood one. So what's my recommendation? You might be sitting there thinking, you know, he's certainly saying a lot of things that lead more towards wood baseball bats. Not so fast. Here's my answer. I think that you should hit with a wood baseball bat in practice, because again, all these good things that we talked about, it's got a smaller sweet spot. It's gonna help you with your plate discipline, your strike zone awareness. It's gonna provide more honest feedback on whether or not you're squaring up the baseball or not, right? There's lots of good things that can be, you know, caused by using a wood baseball bat. It's one of the best tools out there to improve your hitting. But that being said, I do not recommend that you use a wood baseball bat in your games if all of your competition, both your teammates and the opposite team, if all of them are using an aluminum bat, then you're leaving yourself, you're putting yourself at a disadvantage if you're using a wood baseball bat, okay? You know, with a wood bat, you know, you're not gonna get as many hits, plain and simple. Those balls that you miss hit with an aluminum bat, you might, you know, get it past, you know, the six hole or something like that. Those are not gonna fly with a wood baseball bat. And so a wood baseball bat, yes, it's gonna force you to become a better hitter. You're gonna have to learn to properly hit the ball in the sweet spot, but you want every single advantage that you can possibly get in a real game situation. So when you're doing tee work, when you're doing soft toss, front toss, batting practice, you know, when you're in practice throughout the week, or particularly, you know, when you're in the off season, in the summertime, working on your skills, absolutely use a wood baseball bat. It's going to make you a much better hitter. But when you get into real games, or a couple days leading up before you start playing games, switch over to your aluminum bat, because that way it'll give you time to kind of get used to that bat. You don't want to go into a game cold, not used to your bat at all. You have to get used to the way it feels, the way, you know, you handle the baseball bat. But use an aluminum bat in games. Don't put yourself at a disadvantage. Also, don't forget to grab your free Bat Speed Boosters workout. This is a workout filled with drills that are specifically designed to boost your bat speed, which is ultimately gonna help you boost your power. You're gonna hit more doubles and more home runs. So this workout is 100% free. To grab it, all you need to do is click on the link in the first comment. I'm gonna leave the link in that first comment. I'm gonna pin that comment. So scroll down, go check that out right now. Click on that link. All I need is your email address, a good email where I can send that workout to, and that's it. Then you just go through the exercises and watch your bat speed skyrocket over the course of just the next few days. So go ahead and grab that right now. And don't forget to subscribe if you're not already subscribed, because we're coming out with new baseball videos every single week, and I don't want you to miss any of them. So hit that subscribe button. Be sure your notifications are on. I know some players were having, you know, a difficult time. They weren't getting notified whenever we release new videos. So subscribe and turn the notifications on, all right? And until next time, I'm out. Yeah.